What's up?
I am reviewing the Naim Uniti Atom. Yeah, that's been out for a while. Your timing is suspect. Yeah, I get it. It's been a minute. So, I want it. Like, I need it. Like, right now. Man, you can't buy everything that you like. I mean, it's not sustainable. You're not sustainable. Seek help.
Hi, I'm Bob, and you're in the United States of Analog, and oh man, are my kids gonna hate that open.
But you know, I've got to keep my acting chops up. Did you know I'm in Spy Kids 3? I'm also in an episode of Friday Night Lights, but I think my greatest achievement on screen is being in Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives. I don't remember the episode number. If you catch me, put it down below so others can enjoy. Today's show is powered by Origin Hi-Fi in beautiful Austin, Texas. This is not a paid endorsement, but they've been so kind to loan me equipment to review, and I appreciate it. When you're in Austin, hey, give them a visit. Origin Hi-Fi. Now, let's get to it. Yeah, the Naim Uniti Atom has been out for a minute. Years, in fact, and much has been said and written about this little powerhouse. Maybe this video will be the one that finally gets you to pull the trigger and buy one for yourself. If you can swing the $3,800 sticker price, though I've seen some open box deals out there. The Uniti Atom is a Class AB integrated amplifier with DAC, with streamer, AirPlay, Bluetooth. It's mostly meant to be an all-around solution, and you will fall in love with its form factor like I did. Well, if you're wondering about the dimensions of the Naim, I actually fit it in an Air Jordan shoebox. Now, I don't know why anyone would do that, but I did. Lift it up. It's solid, rock solid. It feels like it's stuffed with technology. I'm kind of wondering if the lack of phono preamp included is simply because it wouldn't fit in the case. But while these features add to the wow factor, while you're, you know, 12, 14 feet away from the unit in your listening position there, you're going to be using your handheld device, your smartphone, your iPad, along with the Naim app to control the unit. The album art's not going to have much impact. What might have some impact would be those virtual VU meters that we all love so much on some of the equipment like the NAD models. But the Naim app is easy to install. It works well, maybe not as well as, say, the Blue Sound app, but quite serviceable and quite usable. Oh, by the way, the display is not a touchscreen, though it won't stop you from trying to make it one. There are other simple controls on the front and a beautiful top-lit Naim badge that adds to the premium look. On the back, you can see the limited analog input options, digital connections, HDMI for soundbar replacement options, proprietary Naim speaker connections. Bananas worked fine for me, but I'm not sure that's recommended. By the way, the AC power input has a little bit of wiggle to it when you plug in the cord. I'm told that's part of the power supply isolation. It's by design, so don't pack up the unit. The plastic remote is nice and has a premium look and feel. It's a fingerprint magnet for sure, and some might prefer more rounded edges, but it complements the Atom's aesthetics and gets the job done. You know, when I started buying gear way back in the early 70s in high school and then in college, you know, a man was judged solely on how many watts per channel he had in his system, man. And if you had 40 watts per channel RMS, root mean square, I think that means. I don't remember. No one was coming to your party. You know what I'm talking about? You're going to be sitting alone on a Saturday night. You needed 100 watts or better, but that's not the story anymore in modern times. The Naim has a beautiful, beautiful 40 watts per channel AB class. You know, its rivals in this category usually have class D or digital power. But this amp, along with the Burr Brown DAC, just makes it magical.
Now that's a basic overview of the Naim Uniti Atom. So let's talk about what it can do for you. You know, I'm not a super specky, numbers crunching kind of guy when it comes to audio equipment. I'm all about how the equipment sounds and how it feels to me, okay? My ears are different than yours. My environment is different than yours. The humidity in the air here is different than yours. I all those things that control how something sounds varies, right? I think these days, with the major manufacturers at least, most equipment is getting you 90% there in quality and sound and reliability. I think where we spend all that extra money as quote enthusiasts or audiophiles is in chasing that final 5%, 2%, whatever it is that makes it work for you. And I think that's where the big bucks are. And you know what? 90% for most of us when it comes to buying gear, buying a car, choosing a spouse, is pretty good. It's pretty good for most of us, all right? I'll probably get in trouble for that last part. But I think you know what I'm talking about. It's the law of diminishing returns. My audio buddy Joe says it's all about flavor. And I thought about that for a while, and I think he's absolutely right. There's no right or wrong. I mean, think about this. In the grocery store, Cool Ranch Doritos and Flaming Hot Cheetos are buddies right next to each other on the shelf. And you know what? They both sell really well. There's an audience for both of those flavors. And the same holds true for audio. There's an audience for every piece of equipment out there. So here's how I judge this stuff for myself.
Sound, of course, that's why we're here. Value. Is the juice worth the squeeze? Can I get that 90% satisfaction proposition I mentioned at a reasonable price? Lifestyle. Does it belong in my home? Does it complement my lifestyle and the image I want to project? Will it play nice with others? Emotional attachment. How does it make me feel inside? Do you want to make it a part of your family? Do you want to spend time with it? And there may be other categories, but these are the ones that matter to me, I think. So let's do it. Sound. I was not quite prepared for the sonic impact I got from the Naim Uniti Atom.
Yeah, like you, I had watched all of the reviews and read all of the reviews of the Naim Uniti Atom in the last few years, and even with that in mind, I don't think that I was fully prepared for the impact that the sound had on me. You know, it punched me in the chest like a sixth grade bully at recess. It hits hard, and it's a completely likable sound. It's clear, it's dynamic, it's punchy, it's unoffensive on every level. The Naim tackled all of the speakers I threw at it in this test. The LS50 Metas, the Vestias from Focal, where they did the best was the Klipsch Fortes. I mean, what a combination, right? Those 40 watts and the efficiency and those big speakers, it made every artist sound like they were in the room. Dynamic, punchy, clear, never shouty, tons of personality, long listening periods without fatigue, all selling points. At no time in my listening session, streaming music on my iPad, did I ever get tempted to plug in my studio deck turntable. I mean, I just didn't need it. The streaming sounded so good and so pure and so organic that I just kept playing. The only downside for me with streaming is that sometimes I start jumping all over the place. I'll listen to a half a song and then think of another song and punch that in. I don't think that's a great way to listen to music, but you know, with my turntable, I'll play a side, play a whole album and get into it. But on the Naim Uniti Atom, always tempted to find another track to see how it sounds. In many cases, it was like listening to those tracks for the first time.
Price. To get that kind of system completion and satisfaction under four GERS, well, now that starts looking like a value. Look at what you'll save over the years in shoe leather and gas.
Naim Uniti Atom, yes, you are worth it. Take my money. Take all my money.
Lifestyle. Yeah, it fits my design aesthetic. It's something I could live with for a long time.
Yeah, I really do think that the Naim Uniti Atom can be an endgame system with the right speakers for a lot of people who are tired of the expense and the inconvenience of vinyl, as they say, who are tired of all the cords and cables going everywhere, that want a streamlined look and a streamlined sound, and they're tired of being like John Wayne in The Searchers. You know, the Naim really challenged my idea of what a system could be, and even should be. Its small size made it adaptable to smaller rooms. Its big sound made it work in larger rooms. And, come in close for this, it got spousal approval. 100%, and man, that's half of the game won right there.
Emotional attachment.
Yeah, I was emotionally attached. Everything about it, the whole look, the whole feel, the display, the big Costco 5-gallon pickle jar lid-sized volume knob. How's that for a metaphor? Yeah, I got emotionally attached to this unit. I immediately wanted to adopt it into my family. I mean, everything about it, the form factor is fantastic. That front display, the architectural kind of look on the sides, you know, that look like a heatsink. Maybe it is a heatsink, it probably is. Costco 1-gallon pickle jar lid size, that made it special, and I couldn't keep my hands off it. I also couldn't keep punching the display because I did think it was touchscreen. But you'll get over that in a few months. It's all designed with purpose, and I found myself designing my day around spending more time with the name. Kind of like you used to do when you were young, when you had a new girlfriend. I mean, I'm married now, but I do kind of remember how that felt.
There, I hit all four of my test categories. Now my final thoughts.
So that's my time with the Naim Uniti Atom. And frankly, despite all of the reviews that I've seen over the years on this baby, I wasn't quite prepared for how emotionally attached and connected I got to this unit, this baby. There's something magical inside. I'm not sure exactly what it is, but it's in there, and it's crammed in there with little room to spare. You know, I've always prided myself on my audio system and having a bunch of gear, and my current system has, you know, amps and an assortment of speakers and a CD player and an SACD player and a streamer and sometimes a mini disc player. You know, it can get ridiculous. But at the end of the day, I see myself possibly in another Spider-Verse with a Naim Uniti Atom or some future cousin of it, a pair of good speakers, maybe some Klipsch Lascalas or something. And that's it. That's all I would need. I wouldn't want for more. I dream of a time like that. But for right now, this has to go back from whence it came, unfortunately. But someday, the Uniti Atom will be mine. And maybe in a day not so far away. We'll see you next time in the United States of Analog.